Long before the sun rises, the WHNT News Day begins. Well, actually, it never ends. As our nightside crews are packing up and heading home, our overnight producers are in dark and early to begin work on our morning newscasts.
Mornings are hectic.
There's no time to waste.
And a lot to get done.
Taking action, getting results. You're watching WHNT News 19 this morning.
Good morning, everyone. It is 4:30.
Michelle and Steve certainly don't shy away from the coffee as they jumpstart your day. Ben Smith gives viewers a first peek at the day's weather.
Cool outside, some patchy fog for a few locations.
And overnight reporter Jeff Gray tracks the latest on the morning commute.
We just got off the phone with Alabama State Troopers, and they tell us so far so good, no wrecks to talk about.
As the morning show wraps up, the dayside crews arrive and prepare for the morning editorial meeting.
Good morning, everybody. It's a little after 9. I've got my coffee ready. We're about to head into the morning meeting. It's one of two editorial meetings where we plan who's doing what and what news we plan to cover today.
Meteorologist Ben Smith provides an update on the day's weather outlook as the planning process begins. In this daily meeting, news directors, producers, reporters, our web content manager, and assignment editor discuss the day's staffing and plan what news is a must cover for the day. It's the second Wednesday of the month when Madison County commissioners are regularly scheduled to meet, so I go through the agenda items and possible story ideas with the news team.
The mention of a summer food service program for children.
Plenty of local news fodder expected from the meeting, so I grab my camera and gear and it's out the door. Now, you never say this out loud, of course, but right now things are shaping up to present a relatively straightforward day. There was no wood readily available to knock on.
You don't really even have to look at the agenda of the commission meeting to know there's going to be something of public interest to come out. So we generally make it a must cover just to see what at least we can get from the meeting.
So I go in, sit down, set up, admittedly expecting the usual. Listen, record, and take notes during the meeting, then gather interviews with commissioners afterwards. But before a single motion was seconded, before the first agenda item was even mentioned, we quickly learned one commissioner would have something up his sleeve on this otherwise windy, sleepy Wednesday.
It was a misrepresentation of fact and profoundly disingenuous.
District 6's Bob Harrison decided he had something to say and began to delve into a bombast of the Huntsville City School Board and superintendent over what he called disrespect and exclusion amid the ongoing Department of Justice battle regarding school desegregation orders and rezoning. Hot button, if there ever was one. Journalistic intuition told me to capture every angle possible. I knew seconds into the diatribe, this was juicy, this was news, and this was something no one else but the people in this room knew about. For now.
Real estate numbers are starting to bounce back.
Back at the station, reporter David Kumbrock is on the prowl for stories too.
Several angles.
David makes his initial calls. And the assignment desk manager monitors police and fire scanners as producers begin building rundowns and scripts for their 5, 6, and 6:30 newscasts. Web content manager Claire Aiello works to keep WHNT.com up to date with the latest breaking information. No matter what the size of your screen, when you watch WHNT News 19, you get what you want when you want it. We call that getting results. David Kay is looking to do just that. Clear up concerns for a viewer who says they were improperly ticketed for passing a school bus. So with his gear in tow, it's off to the New Hope Police Department to get the story straight on highway school bus laws. David chats with the police captain, but hasn't received a call back from the viewer who asked us for help, so he'll need to get a move on.
Thanks a lot for being with us. It's Friday afternoon. I'm Carrie Marchese, and first up, we have the weather.
Back in Huntsville, Carrie Marchese and meteorologist Brandon Chambers bring our viewers the midday news.
Right now, it's still a couple of hours away for western areas, even further away from central and eastern portions of the Tennessee Valley.
Back at the shop, the afternoon meeting has begun to fill everyone in on the day's progress. It's the 2 p.m. brainstorming session. The nightside reporters join in to pitch story ideas for the 9 and 10 p.m. broadcast as the producers go through every line of their upcoming newscast to decide lead story options. Back at the courthouse, I'm still tied up with
disgust.
I'm telling you, he went off. As soon as the meeting adjourned, I knew I had to get the ear of one Bob Harrison. I knew what just happened was going to be broadcast to thousands, and he did too. But first, I had to feverishly craft the web copy and get the story online as soon as possible, hours before my actual report would air. Meanwhile, Clarissa McLean and Lee Marshall get ready for the 5 p.m. newscast as the folks in Master Control get all the technical workings in order. With the anchors in place and ready to roll, it's go time.
3, 2, 1, opens up, turns the...
Taking action, getting results. You're watching WHNT News 19 at 5.
This morning, a Madison County commissioner lashed out at Superintendent Casey Wardinsky and the school board, saying they have excluded the community and elected officials on the rezoning debate. David Wood was at the commission meeting and is live now at the courthouse to outline this school board blasting. David?
Well, Clarissa, District 6 Commissioner Bob Harrison wasted no time going in on Huntsville City School Superintendent, and he even brought along reinforcements.
I don't believe that in my 50 plus years of professional and community service have I seen such a display of arrogance, deception, deceit, such that when we talk about being together as a community, just defies, in essence, everything that we are supposed to be about.
Bob Harrison says he also wants the commission to seek a meeting with the superintendent and the school board. But beyond that, he's also calling for a little community outrage. No other commissioner spoke in support of seeking such a meeting with the school board. Reporting live in Huntsville, David Wood, WHNT News 19. The average news day here at WHNT News 19 is never average. It's hectic, deadline-driven, and can often bring unexpected encounters. But we love it, and we do it every day in an effort to bring our viewers the most local news in Huntsville. 34 and a half hours of regularly scheduled news a week, on air and on the web. WHNT News 19, taking action, getting results for you.